All right, so I just want to do a short review on this World of WarCraft Cataclysm mouse, just for a couple of minutes here. It's basically one of my favorite macro button mice to this date, just because it has really good placements on some of these buttons here, and just the way that it feels with my thumb. These grooves are very, I don't know, it just feels really nice. So it's $100 retail price. I wouldn't say it's worth $100. I would say about maybe $80 is about right. But I found it pretty cheap online for about that $80 price tag. But $100, I probably wouldn't get it for $100. It's definitely a light mouse. I was expecting it to be a little heavy, but it's definitely light, and it's definitely big. I'm sure some of you guys have probably seen the other WoW mouse, and that one's pretty big as well. Like I said, this one doesn't have that ugly kind of weird curve on the bottom of it. This one actually has some really good curvature to it for your thumb and your pinky as well. I do want to say though that since it is light, it's not designed for other applications. So if you want to play, well, actually, I shouldn't say that. I should say just first-person shooters in general. If you want to play first-person shooters, I want to say this is a no-go. For first-person shooters, I'd probably go with something like this, like the RAD 7. But this one definitely not for first-person shooters. Definitely for MMOs and any other game that's kind of RPG-ish in a way, kind of like the like Dragon Age, for example, is what I've been playing. This mouse is perfect for that. Other than that, it is pretty big, like I said before, pretty light. It definitely feels good on the palm and on your hand. But if you do want to pick up the mouse, it's not the greatest, because you have to, I'm sure a lot of you probably pick up your mice using your thumb, of course, right? The thumb and then your pinky. So as you're holding the mouse, you want to use your thumb to try to lift it up a little bit, just to try to move it over. But because that there are buttons here, you're going to kind of tend to press some of these, so you usually have to grip it right about here, and then for the pinky it does here too. So yeah, it lights up as well. You can have it pulsate, or you can have it just constantly being lit up as well. And the software is pretty basic. It's kind of what you find on any other program out there. You just, you know, hotkey to whatever buttons you want to these things here too. So it's a good mouse. I've played with it for a couple days here, and I've enjoyed it with a lot of my MMOs and RPG games too, so this is definitely a good go for those kind of things. But for first-person shooters, no, I'd definitely go for a different mouse.